All right, number 6 on my top 20 fantasy mod list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. Call of Warhammer, Beginning of the End Times, Alternative Cut. So Beginning of the End Times was a submod of Call of Warhammer, mod made by Russian modders. And Alternative Cut is a submod of Beginning of the End Times, made by the user Talla over at the Discord for Beginning of the End Times. So the mod was removed from the Discord, and Kalla took a break. I don't know exactly why, but personal reasons has been cited as the reason. So he released Alternative Cut in March of 2019, and I have hardly played it. I have checked it out and tried some battles as the Amazons. So this submod aimed to make the campaign more varied. Instead of having 10 Empire factions, you have bunch of new factions that are not all the same. So let's go to the grand campaign. So we have a bunch of factions. We still have 31 factions in the mod. You can see that we have the Empire as one single faction now, starting here, instead of 10 factions or maybe 8 factions in 2.0 of Beginning of the End Times. There used to be 10 in Call of Warhammer and in the earlier versions of Beginning of the End Times. Then we have the Warriors of Chaos. So the Warriors part of the Chaos factions have become one faction. We have the Norse as one faction, just like in Call of Warhammer. We have the Black Orcs, now a single faction. They are the big Black Orcs, the heavily armored Orcs, stronger ones. Then we have the Orcs and Goblins, like Green Orcs and Goblins combined into one faction. That's the old Orc faction. Well, the Black Orcs were like elite units in the old Orcs and Goblins faction. Now they are faction on their own. We have the Undead Legions down here. I don't know much about them, but they are another Undead faction, the third one. And then we have the Chaos Dwarves. It's a bunch of Chaos-believing Dwarves that use, I believe, hobgoblins and goblins as slaves, and even orcs as slaves in their armies. So they have mostly goblins, orcs, and hobgoblins in their armies fighting for them. But they also have some dwarven units, of course, and siege engines that are pretty good. And they are evil, of course. They are chaos believers, just like the chaos factions. We have the Skaven, and they are down here, the rats. Then we have the Savage Orcs. They are also their own faction now. They are more like lightly clad orcs. We have the Ogre Kingdoms. So they are still a faction on their of their own. Giant Ogres. Guns and such. We have Night Goblins. The old Goblin faction. It's like the Goblin part of the Orcs and Goblins, but independent from the Orcs. And they also have cool squig hoppers, cavalry, and wolf cavalry and such. Then we have the Vampire Counts, the vampires that are resurrecting the dead. So they have skeletons fighting for them and such, werewolves and other stuff. But it's a vampire faction, an undead vampire faction. The leaders are vampires. And then we have the Tomb Kings, like an undead Egyptian faction, not unlike the Kingdom of Cana in Herald of War. They are Egyptian based and they are undead. We have the Dark Elves over here, and they are led by the Witch King Malekit, and yeah, they are about the same as in other earlier versions of the mod and as in Call of Warhammer, but with more creatures and more units. And then we have the Wood Elves in the old world. They have about 2 areas, I believe, and are led by their king, I believe. Here we have the High Elves in Ultan, holding most of Ultan. We have the Lizard Men down here. We have a new faction here, the Dukedom of Mosillon. I believe that's an undead vampire faction as well. So Mosillon is a vampire faction. That means there are 4 undead factions in this mod now. And then we have Marineburg, know if they are undead or not, but they do. They are independent from the other factions there. Marienburg is its own faction. And then we have the Pestle and Rats, the Skaven. I believe this mod was first with adding the Vampire Coast and the Pestle and Skaven. And the Tomdorf, the main modder of Beginning of the End Times, decided to remove two of the Empire factions to add these two factions, Pestilence and the Vampire Coast, because he was inspired by this mod, I believe, to add them. Okay, then we have the Beasts of Chaos. So the Beasts are now playable and are one faction. So you can play as the Beasts of Chaos and you can play as the Warriors of Chaos. Or you can play as the Norse. And then we have the Sultanate of Araby, a new faction. Completely new units. We have the Kingdoms of Istalia, like a Spaniard Warhammer faction. Previously just rebels, just like Araby, but now playable. We have City-States of Tilia, probably Greek-inspired or Italy-inspired, maybe both. Based off of Italy and Greece, actually. Okay, then we have the Halflings. By the way, Araby and Tilia and Istalia, they were all in the old versions of Beginning of the End Times, but they weren't factions in their own right. Instead, they were a part of the rebel factions, but had, I believe, Beginning of the End Times used, I believe, a changed AI on the campaign map. So rebel factions would attack and such. So Tilia, Araby and Istalia were on the map as rebels and they would attack the player and such and other factions, but they weren't factions in their own right. And I believe that the creator of this submod, Alternative Cut, submod of Beginning of the End Times, he added a lot of new units to the factions. So they are not the same as in Beginning of the End Times. They may have some of the same units, but there are many new units too. He has filled out all the new factions, so they have proper rosters. In Beginning of the End Times, I believe that they had some cool units, but it wasn't enough for an entire faction. So here he has actually filled out the rosters. And we have the Halflings. You can play as the Hobbits of Warhammer, pretty much. They are named Halflings in the Warhammer world, and not Hobbits. But they are pretty much Hobbits, and they used to be like a part of the Empire factions in earlier versions of Beginning of the End Times and Call of Warhammer, I believe. I think there were maybe one Halfling unit or something in one of the Empire factions, but here they are their own faction. It's pretty cool. And then we have the Amazons. You can play as an all-female faction, the one I tried to play as, but I can tell you that, well, they have a proper roster and they look great and such, and have cool mounts like panthers and such. They are not very strong. They are a ranged faction like the elves. So they are best from afar, so they are not very strong in melee, and that's why they have a problem fighting the Lizardmen or the Skaven. The Skaven are very numerous, so when I played in the immersion mod or third person mod, it was very annoying because they would lose when I put them under AI control, because they weren't good enough. And if I play them manually, I could probably do way better with them, but then I can't use the immersion mod as much. You know, I used to place my own unit in the immersion mod, so I can play as the general, and then the armies would be placed under AI control, but the AI did poorly. They also used to send in the ranged units in melee, unfortunately, so they were all slaughtered. So I believe if I'm gonna play this campaign, I will use the third person mod from time to time, but I will have to be careful with the ranged units and place them. I believe I will have to have the ranged units under my manual control. I can't trust the AI with those units. But this is a really cool faction. We have the Vampire Coast, same faction that Tomdorf added to 2.0 of Beginning of the End Times. We have the Kingdom of Kislev, we have the Kingdom of Britannia, and we have the Dwarves. Okay. So we checked the Amazons in a previous video where I previewed this mod, but we could instead take a look at the Halflings and the map. And by the way, this is the most recent version of Alternative Cut available. So, Bent Chieftain, the main modeler of Warcraft Total War models, he rigged most of the models in Warcraft Total War. There were one other guy who helped as well, but he only worked on models, I believe, the first 2 months in 2017 when we restarted development of the mod. I believe between March and May of 2017, another guy were working on models. But Ben Chieftain joined the team in May 2017, and since then he was the modeler. The guy who rigged all the models on Warhammer and Hyrule animations and such. Believe that he made some fixes and patches for this mod, for the version that released in March of 2019. But in April this year, 2021, Bent Chieftain actually finished a much bigger patch where he fixed the balancing issues and removed some there were some units that had like one defense and one attack. He removed those units and added other units from the files, because there is a 500 unit limit in Medieval Total War Kingdoms, so Kala had to remove certain units to add his new units, and I believe Bantu re-enabled some of the units that were not in use and removed some others that were really basic and not very good. But anyway, this version should have much better balance, and the costs should be fixed and such. It's more playable. I haven't played it much. I said I played a little bit as the Amazons with this version a few months back, but that was just a test. I want to play this mod. I want to play this mod more than the other one. You see, I played the original Call of Warhammer a lot between 2009 and 2012, so I don't want to play version 1.6 of Call of Warhammer, and I would prefer Beginning of the End Times over that one, because it's less scripted and has improved in many areas. But if I compare Beginning of the End Times 2.0 with this version, Alternative Cut, then I actually prefer this one. Oh, by the way, there were an intro message to an event pick there. I believe all the factions have that. But anyway, this version, I believe, would be most interesting to play, because the 2.0 version of Beginning of the End Times, well, being a huge improvement over the original mod, is still a mod with the same factions and some new ones. So if I am gonna play it, I would play something new, but still it's very much the same but improved. This one is more unique with all the new factions and removed older factions and such, so this one is more in my taste. I like mods that have many different unit types and such. So for example, I prefer having a bunch of unique factions over having, as I said, 10 Empire factions. So this mod I am actually more interested in playing. I've never played a proper campaign in it. I've never played the Beginning of the End Times either. But I am playing, I believe, a submod for Beginning of the End Times that I made in 2016 and 2017. It was finished on January 2018. So I made a submod of the original release, version 1.1, I believe, of Beginning of the End Times. but that version has a smaller map and fewer units and fewer animations and such, so it's not as good as 2.0. But yeah, it's I am playing that version. Besides that version, I haven't really played Beginning of the End Times. I have been too busy modding. I haven't played this one much either. But if I'm gonna play one of the Beginning of the End Times mods, I will probably play this one. But as you can see, we have a huge, impressive map. It's about as big as the map from 2.0, but it's slightly different. Certain areas, and this area is connected. There's no water between the continent here, which is much better for the AI, as they have problems using ships in this mod. They usually use them to block ports, blockade ports and such, but not to really land troops. It can happen, but it's rare. They're really bad at doing that type of stuff. Okay, they are also, I believe, this version has no land connection over here, unlike Beginning of the End Times 2.0. I believe they added land here between the Chaos Wastes here and the Dark Elven lands. Here they do not have any land bridge. Okay, and see that there are a bunch of cool factions with unique strat models. Now I don't know exactly where they are. There are a bunch of unique custom settlement models on the map as well. And I believe Kalla, the creator of this submod, Alternative Cut, he not only added new factions, new units, new strat models, etc. But he also added some new custom settlements in battle. Not too many, but there are new ones. New ones for the Wood Elves, for the Skaven, for the Chaos factions, and for the Orcs, I believe. And maybe someone else. I believe also that he added new ones for the Norska or the Chaos faction, the Norskans, I believe. Because I used, with permission from Kalla, some of the Norskan custom settlements for every kill in Warcraft of the War. They fit perfectly. Okay, so we have a halfling priestess here. So it's a priestess agent. We have a merchant here. And a spy. So many regions do we have as the halflings? We have three regions. We have an entire army, halfling militia, great eagle riders, housewives. They even had figures in Games Workshop. So they are a proper faction in Warhammer. Didn't know that. I thought they were like a yoke faction, but they are probably a yoke faction. But I mean, I didn't know they had actual figurines. Okay, so this faction and the Hobbit faction of Third Age Reforged are very similar, and they have similar units. Here we have Great Eagle Riders, there we had Eagles, and yeah, but I think the Warhammer one is more impressive because it has more unique monsters and such. I think the unit variation is a little bit better here. In the Third Age mod, I believe most of them use the same old male model as a base, while here they have unique siege, like hotpots, and they have treemen, they have poachers, they have soats. Okay, so they have more unit variation here, which I like. If I'm gonna play this version of the mod, then I will play the halflings or the Amazons. Probably I will play both. I like the idea of conquering the world as the halflings, but I also like the idea of playing the all-female Amazon faction. Okay, so this mod is very impressive and has about the same size for its map as in Beginning of the End Times, just slightly different. We could start a quick battle, but we won't do that. Instead, we will pick the factions that are most unique. So I think we will pick the Amazons and the Halflings. I think they are cool. We'll just check them. You can see we have Coca-Cola and Veilers with daggers. We have the Totem Guardians, Warriors with 200 weapons. We have the Amazon Spearwomen, the Amazon Bodyguard. They should lead the army. So it's a dismounted bodyguard. We have Amazon Tribeswoman. We have Kalim Devouts, Warriors with Sunstaff. We have the Serpent Priestesses, really good mages. And we have Jaguars, a really cool unit. And then we have Pterodon Riders, Cold One Riders. So even the Amazons are using Cold Ones, just like the Lizardmen and the Dark Elves. And then we have Panther Riders, and we have Pygmies. Okay, so it's a really cool faction. By the way, I forgot the Coatls. So it's clearly Aztec inspired, just like the Elves. And it's a ranged faction, like the Elves, so they're bodyguard is a ranged bodyguard. Then we have the Halflings. They have some mercenaries here too. From other factions. Let's see, we need the their so they have some dwarven and elven mercenaries. Then they have some ogre mercenaries, some human mercenaries probably too, and dwarves, yeah. But their bodyguard is probably the Motland Champions cavalry unit. I believe they ride sheep, actually, it's pretty cool. So we'll just take some of these. We don't want any dwarves or such. Let's see, Dwarf Axe, we'll remove it. Poachers, I think, could be kept. Great Eagle Riders, Soats, Hot Pots, Treemen, Raised Cooks, Halfling Militia, Housewives, Cooks, Gatherers, Sheep Dogs, and we have War Sheep Riders, Battle Ram Riders. So they have sheeps and they have rams and they have Motland Champions. Okay, let's start the game. The battle, I mean. So we'll take a look at this. I also believe that the loading screens might be different from beginning to end times, but I'm not 100% certain that's the case. But this version, Alternative Cut, has way more custom settlements in battle, because Kalla, the creator, made custom settlements specifically for this submod. And by the way, he's remaking this submod. He's removing the Norskan faction and the Halfling faction. Maybe something else as well, because he wants to add other parts of the world. Add a faction based on Japan, and a faction based on India, and a faction based on China. And in order to have new factions, he needs to remove certain factions, because he has already reached the limit. If you want anything new, you need to remove something old. So the Amazon faction, we have the Panther Riders, really cool unit. I like variations like this, something we haven't seen before. And the Pterodon Riders, they fly when they run, at least, but they start on the ground, really cool. Dinosaur mount, flying dinosaur. We have the Cold Ones, the Cold One Riders. Amazons. We have the Jaguars, an animal handler unit, but without handlers. So like the Fellhounds and Snapdragons and such of Warcraft of the War. Okay, it's a really cool Jaguar unit. We have their bodyguard, ranged bodyguard, but they also have spears their backs that they will use if they are in a melee, I believe, so they are good in melee too. We have the pygmies, small like creatures, then we have the serpent priestesses, they're mages, and they actually float in the air or levitate in the air. Really cool unit. Look great too. Then we have the Kalim Devotes, another missile unit. So they have two mage units. One dismantled and one that is levitating. And then we have the Amazon tribeswomen. They're probably basic spearmen, archers and or bowmen. Then we have the Totem Guardians, heavy melee, heavy infantry. We have the Amazon spearwomen. They throw javelins, but they can also fight in melee with spears. A mix between range and infantry, but they are light. And then we have the Kukakalem, light infantry, knives in battle. Okay, feel like I've missed something. Here we have the Quattles. Remind me of the Naga Quattles. So they have a giant equivalent of a dragon here. Really dangerous unit. And I think we're done checking the Amazons. And then we can check just for fun the halflings too. We have the cooks here. We have poachers. Like, I don't know what their weapon is, bows. I thought so. Okay, then we have housewives. They have like these things that they use as a weapon. I believe it's the same. I don't know the word, the English word, but it's something you use when you cook food, I believe. So this is clearly a yoke faction. We have halfling militia. We have cooks. We have the eagle riders, great eagle riders. They looked cool. And here they are riding the eagles. We have the Ent-styled units, the treemen. We have the sheep riders, war sheep riders actually. The sheep have horns, of course. We have the hotpot siege engine, a ballista. Reminds me of the Kokiri siege engines, they looked almost the same. And the size of these guys are probably the same as the Kokiri, just they are a little bit more fat. And they are not children of the forest like the Kokiri are. Here they are more like ordinary men and women, but smaller. Okay, and then we have the sheep dogs. Look more like wolves than dogs. They are dogs. Very aggressive dogs. We have these old creatures, the Suets. Centaur-styled monsters. Giant maces. Seem to be lizards. Then we have the champions here. Okay, so those are two of the new factions. We won't check any others. We won't play the battle. So I've spoken enough already. But this is number 6 on my top 20 fantasy list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. And it's debatable if this one or the 2.0 one is better. But I believe this one is less polished compared to the other one. But in my opinion, the more interesting mod, as I played older versions of Beginning of the End, of Call of Warhammer, and this one is more unique than the other one. So I think this one will be more interesting to play for me. Okay, but thank you for watching, and we will continue on the list with the 5th mod on the list. Bye. Number 5 on my top 20 fantasy mod list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. Warcraft Total War is the mod. So, as I said previously, it's debatable if the Warhammer Begin of the End Times mod version 2.0 or the Warhammer Begin of the End Times mod at the native cut should be higher up than Warcraft Total War. If it was based on how polished it is and gameplay features and such, then it's debatable. But this is my list of top 20 mods, and I prefer Warcraft over Warhammer. It's also a mod I worked on, so I'm biased here too. But my opinion is that without Beginning of the End Times, we wouldn't have this mod. But this mod is still my favorite out of the three. So I place it as the number 5 mod on the top 20 fancy list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. For some reason we have a 2D background. That shouldn't be the case normally, but there seem to be some issues with videos not working in Game of Thrones Enhanced and in Warcraft Total War. All of a sudden they worked previously, I don't know why they do not work now. Something with the Medieval Total War engine overhaul project tool, probably version 2.0. Yeah, it shouldn't happen, and I have no idea why it is happening, but it is happening. Okay, so we have two campaigns. We have the Reign of Chaos campaign and we have the Frozen Throne campaign. In the Reign of Chaos campaign, you have the following factions playable. You have the Rikul, you have the Ankirai faction, you have the Amani Trolls, you have the Kingdom of Lordaeron, Kingdom of Stormwind, you have Terramor, you have the Kasmodan Dwarves, you have the Kingdom of Kvel'Thalas, which is the High Elves, and you have the Dark Iron Dwarves actually, and then you have the Dark Horde, which is the evil horde from Warcraft 2. You have the Kingdom of Azul Nerub, the Spider Kingdom. You have the Night Elves. You have the Scourge. You have the Drakari Ice Trolls, Giant Ice Trolls in Northrend. You have the Kingdom of Strumgard. You have the Faraki Trolls. They are like, they are like Sand Trolls in Kalimdor. You have the Horde. You have the Burning Legion, which is the demons. And you have the Trade Coalition, the Goblins, and then you have the Gurbashi Trolls, Jungle Trolls in Eastern Kingdoms. Okay, so the difference between the Trolls are that the Faraki Trolls are smaller Trolls, and the Gurbashi are also smaller Trolls, and these are Sand Trolls, and the others are Jungle Trolls. Then the Ice Trolls are a mix between smaller Trolls and bigger Trolls, just like the Amani Trolls. But the Drakari Trolls are Ice Trolls in Northrend, and the Amani Trolls are Forest Trolls in Eastern Kingdoms. So we have Forest Trolls, we have Ice Trolls, we have Sand Trolls, and we have Jungle Trolls. And the Jungle and Sand Trolls are smaller, while the Ice Trolls and the Forest Trolls are bigger, but they also have smaller units too. Okay, and in Frozen Throne campaign, which is a custom campaign, we have other factions playable, we have many of the same as well. So the same factions we just saw, minus the High Elves of Kvel'Thalas, they are no longer playable. Instead you have the Blood Elves, also known as the Sindori. So instead of the High Elves of Kvel'Thalas, you have, or the Kingdom of Kvel'Thalas, you have the Sindori Blood Elves playable here. And Lordaeron is much smaller, so you have the Forsaken playable too, led by Sylvanas Windrunner. In the other campaign, she is a general in the Kingdom of Kvel'Thalas faction and is alive as a High Elf. Here she is an undead leader of the Forsaken. And the Blood Elves, their leader here, Kaltas, Prince Kaltas, he is a prince, I believe, in the Kingdom of Kvel'Thalas faction in the other campaign. Okay, and that faction is led by his father, King something. And then we have the Naga playable in this campaign as well, led by Illidan Stormrage. So they are not playable in the other campaign. But I believe in the other campaign that the Blood Elves and the Forsaken spawn during the campaign, while the Naga, they do not spawn. They only spawn, the Blood Elves and Forsaken, if certain conditions are met. Okay, and then in this campaign we also have the Scarlet Crusade, and they are no longer available in the other campaign. So we're gonna check the map as some faction. We'll only check the Frozen Throne campaign. We can check probably the, let's see here, we have could check the Night Elves actually. Oh, it crashed here too. That means I need to play a quick battle before I start. I forgot. Okay, be right back. Alright. So we're back. So this mod, of course, has unique loading screens. I loaded a saved game. Didn't bother with the quick save, but yeah, when you start a new campaign in this mod, you need to start up a quick battle first, or a custom battle. But it's easier to just click quick battle. It's faster. You don't need to play the battle, you can just exit the main menu immediately, and then you can start the campaign, it will work. But if you have old saves, you can just load them up. So, Warcraft Total War version 2.2 is this version. It released the latest version in May 5th, this year, 2021. So, I added about 60 plus strat models for different factions in this mod. It's not finished. Certain factions still need new models, but yeah, I added a quite update back then. So I loaded my save here. We'll just not attack. We'll click toggle FAU. So I'm playing a let's play actually on my YouTube channel as the Naga and the Blood Elves in a combined hot seat campaign, and this is the campaign. We are currently on the Blood Elven turn. I'm not gonna play right now. We'll take a look at the map. You can see that the Vrykul are still holding this area of Northrend, and they're holding all their starting areas. Still haven't taken this area from the Iron Doran rebels. And there are a bunch of rebel areas here between the Vrykul and the Ice Trolls, the Drakari. So they haven't done much, even though they have some armies up here. In rebel territory, we have the Scarlet Crusade in this Frozen Throne campaign. So they have an area here. Scarlet Fleet's holdout. We have the Trade Coalition here, the Goblins in Venture Bay. We have the Ice Trolls. They have a standoff with the Scourge, so some of the Scourge armies are focusing on the Ice Trolls and such. And then we have the Kingdom of Azul Nerub, the Spider Kingdom. And we have the Scourge, of course, with their capital, Ice Crown. And they are led by the Witch, by the Lich King, Ner'zhul, in this mod. But Death Knight Arthas is also in the mod. We have killed him already in this campaign. We have the Naga down here, led by Illidan Stormrage and Lady Vash. You could see that Illidan has his own model on the map here. He's the leader of the Naga. We also have Lady Vash over here, the commander of the Naga forces. We have the Blood Elves, led by Kaltas, the prince. And we have some rebel areas we can conquer with different creatures. So in Kalimdor, you have the Night Elves, and they also have completely fresh models on the map, like Dryad Merchants. This is now the Diplomat of the Naga. Sirens there. We have new Priests of the Night Elves. The Burning Legion has new models too. So they have a new general here, Rat Guard General, and a Fell Soldier model. And their heroes have unique models too. The Trolls didn't get anything new, and the Ankerai faction hasn't gotten anything new yet either. So they have the same models as previously in older versions, but I'm gonna add new ones to them too. We have Terramor over here, and in this campaign I believe that Terramor started allied with the Horde, but that alliance seems to have been broken. I didn't know this, because I haven't checked the map prior to this, but they are under siege. Their heroes like Jaina and Kaskar, they have unique strat models too. The only unique one for the Horde currently that has been updated is the one for Troll. Here we have Kaskar. No, advisor Tervash. It is using a model based on Kaskar from Warcraft 1, I believe. Okay. I don't know where Jaina is. She might be in Terramore, the capital, or somewhere else. Okay, in this area we have the capital of the Trade Coalition. The goblins have areas in many continents. We have an area down here too. They do not have any new models. None of the trolls have that either. And I haven't started with the Stormwind faction. But we have many factions available to play to be played. The only humans I did work on was the Lordran faction and Terramore. I finished Terramore. And I did some work on Lordran and the Scarlet Crusade. But I didn't finish them. Okay, the dwarves haven't gotten anything new either. Okay. But, yeah, we have a custom campaign. We have two different campaigns. The difference is that they have different starting positions and different factions. Even though many factions are in both campaigns. But one is an earlier setting, so they might be weaker or stronger in one of the campaigns. Yeah, compared to the other. Okay, and then let's click on Quick Battle. Let's check the models. Some random factions. And this mod has custom music, custom settlements in many places, borrowed from other mods with unique reskins of the textures. And it has custom models everywhere. From Warcraft 3 and Warcraft 3 fandom and from World of Warcraft. So no more Warhammer models like in the past. I believe they used Warhammer models before we got all the Warcraft models in. But then it might have some siege engines from Warhammer, Beginning of the End Times. And all the models are rigged on Beginning of the End Times animations or Hyrule animations or vanilla animations. So any weird creature is based on either Hyrule or Beginning of the End Times. Here we have the Abominations of the Scourge, really cool half-giant unit. We have some skeletons. So the Scourge is one of the older factions that the modeler Eogan Wolfkin worked on. All his models looked more like fan-made models. Like the ghouls here. They were either from Warcraft 3 or fandom. These are probably based on Elder Scrolls models with unique armor and such. Helmets that look more Warcraft than Elder Scrolls. These guys are later models for the faction. I believe half the Scourge roster has Warcraft models and the other half is fan-made. Okay. But all the rosters by Band Chieftain have World of Warcraft or Warcraft 3 fan-made models. While Eogan Wolfkin used some original models. They're made by Band Chieftain, but he made an entire roster out of it. I believe Band Chieftain made a footman and a knight, and Eogan Wolfkin made an entire human roster based on that, and also they used the undead, I believe, too, for that, I believe, from Elder Scrolls. Here we have a guide unit, the Mud Golems. The only giant unit in use by all the humans. So it's Terramore they are facing here. Okay, we have unique textures for the Marka horses too. It's just Marka horse with a unique Warcraft skin. Okay. And of course civilian animations from Hyrule War. But as you can see, custom models, custom map, custom music, custom loading screens and everything. There should be a video in the background too. I have no idea why it isn't playing. Something is wrong. Because it played the last time I played this game. But anyway, this is Warcraft Total War version 2.2. And in my opinion, it's on the 5th place on my top 20 fantasy mod list for medieval Total War Kingdoms. But it can be debatable if the Beginning of the End Times 2.0 or Alternative Cut should be higher up than this mod. But on my list, this one will be above the Warhammer mods. Okay. And now the next one.